order to travel through time, you need a device known as a flux capacitor. Well, that's what the mad professor from Back to the Future would like you to believe. But then that stuff movies are made of. Today, I have a device that will actually take us into the future with a name cooler than a flux capacitor and definitely better looking. This one's called the Emflux One. I say future because the Emflux One is way ahead of its time. It is already an electric sports bike in a country where electric vehicles are mostly scooters and rickshaws. It is already an electric sports bike in a country which has never made a superbike till date. And looking at it, you might think that it has been built in a state-of-the-art facility with shiny white floors by men wearing perfectly pressed lab coats. But no. Instead, the Emflux One was conceptualized here in a startup office in the heart of Bangalore, made by overworked people who kept missing meals and repeated their t-shirts. But they all had something in common.
I'm Varun. I'm the co-founder and CEO of Emflux Motors. We started this company around 2.5 years back.
I'm Vinayraj Somshekar. I'm 32 years old. Mainly in India, there's a big misconception that electric vehicles are slow and boring and flimsy and badly designed and unreliable. What we wanted to make was a product that completely shatters these misconceptions. So initially, it was just Varun, one mechanical engineer and three electronics guys. And now we have grown to 21 people.
The main piece of the puzzle is the electric vehicle technology, which we have been developing since the inception.
Once we develop the technologies to run an electric superbike, it'll be easier for us to build any sort of vehicle that we want.
First things first, it is said to be a sports bike, so it looks like one. For example, you can see a bit of the KTM RC8 in a way. This vertical LED headlamp setup splits the full fairing in half. And then you have the race tail section, which again looks like a bit of the KTM RC8. But that's just the looks. When we talk about the components, we have got Ohlins and Brembos taking care of suspension and braking, something that you'll see on high-end superbikes. What is unique to the Emflux, however, is the motor. There's no high-revving inline 4 or a parallel twin engine. This one is pure electric. It's making about 72 HP and 84 Newton meters of torque. Now, I know this might not sound like a lot, but the final production version is going to weigh in at about 169 kilograms. And all of that torque is going to be available right from the word go.
Emflux claims that 0 to 100 can be achieved in about 3 seconds, which is faster than a Ferrari 458. Keep the throttle pinned and you will eventually reach 200 kilometers per hour. But this is a prototype and it's performing at about 40% of its peak performance. But even after that, you still feel that silent torque punch.
With a bike this fast, you're expecting things to be a little racier, aggressive. But surprisingly, things are a lot more comfortable here. The rider's triangle is very balanced, something that you will find on a Yamaha R3. But in the final production version, there is going to be some tinkering around with the way the foot pegs are placed and also this seat. This prototype has got quite a firm seat, but in the final version, they're going to add more foam and overall things are going to look a lot better.
Keeping you glued onto the road are Pirelli Diablo Rosso 2 tires. These aren't just good for the road, but should also work well on the track if you like spending weekends in a leather race suit.
With a wheelbase of 1395 mm, the One is a very manageable motorcycle in the city. And when we talk about heating, it does not heat up as much. It'll keep your legs cool, unlike traditional sports bikes.
The first prototypes that we built were probably not as good as the ones we have right now. So in terms of the design process, that's the main challenge that we have faced, but somehow we have come out of it and I think we have a decent enough design for now.
We have a whole battery pack which weighs around 50 kgs. It is composed of 896 cylindrical 18650 cells. This is what enables us to get so much performance out of our bike.
The batteries have another advantage, range. Now Emflux says that you can cover up to 200 kilometers on a single charge and about 160 when you're out on the highway. For reference, the most efficient EV in the country today can do about 100. And because there isn't any exhaust note to accompany, it feels all too surreal. It is like someone has opened the floodgates to hell while Beethoven plays in your earphones. I can't even imagine what it'll be with its full potential unlocked. More time away still is the infrastructure for such vehicles in our country, but Emflux claims that their warp charger can charge the one from 0 to 80% in just about 36 minutes. Because of the lithium-ion battery pack, the bike feels light. It's placed in a stack of 7 right where your fuel tank should be. So it looks good, is fast, and is pretty comfortable for your daily commute too. What more? It is from the future as well. Is this a dream then? Unfortunately, it is. The downside of the lithium-ion batteries, the Ohlins setup, the Brembo brakes and the Pirelli tires is the price. Now Emflux says that when this finally hits production form, this is going to cost about 6 lakh rupees. And then you have the question of when. The One is still a prototype, which means there's still time for it to go into production. Having ridden the Emflux, I have seen a glimpse of the future, and I'm convinced that the future isn't a bad place to be after all.